What's up, guys? We are back. We are here to help gyms build a cash room and bring home 20K per month plus in profit. It's Anthony Bevilacqua alongside Jimmy McCurry. And today we're going to be talking about the number one play that you need to do to grow your gym. And I wish I would have thought about this a little bit more in the beginning, man, because everybody talks about, I'm trying not to give it away, but everybody talks about this being the most important thing that you need to do.
Yeah.
But everybody does a shit job at explaining what it is and how to do it. So I'm excited to break this down for everyone today so they could take home and build that cash room for themselves. So should we drum roll it and then let everyone know what it is?
I guess so.
All right. So the number one play to grow your gym is referrals.
Yeah,
referrals, the best. And I was actually doing a meeting with my sales staff the other day, and I said, listen, if every lead that we get in the gym, if we sign them up and we get two referrals from them, we've essentially earned three people from one lead. That's huge. Think about that. You're 3xing your business every single time that you do this. And referrals are the best one, the best way to do it as far as growing your business, because that actually shows that people like your service. So referrals is huge, but it's like an infinite return when you do that. So we actually created a referrals program, and I'll talk about it a little bit when we get into it, but we created a referrals program, and it's basically four levels deep, how we created the program. So if it's four levels deep, that means that every client who comes in is automatically has the ability to send us at least four referrals based on the, you know, if we gamified the whole referral thing. But think about it. If that actually comes true and every client brings four clients in, that's a lot.
It's a ton, man. And referrals, especially as a new business, you know, if I refer to these guys that are either just starting out or can't quite break past 20K in revenue, referrals are going to be the biggest way that you can grow your business while still remaining profitable, because you don't have the $3,000 to $5,000 a month to spend on Facebook advertising, right? You're trying to pay yourself, you're trying to eat. And the easiest way to grow your business in the beginning is referral, right? And a lot of people do a horrible job of asking for referrals, right? And there's a couple of things that go into referrals that make them so great for your business. At this stage in our business, about 30% of our new clients come from referrals per year, right? So if we didn't have referrals coming into our business, then we wouldn't have the growth that we have. We wouldn't be at the stage that we're in, because it accounts for 30% of our business, our new business every year, right? Now, how do you get these referrals and how do you garner referrals from your current member base? Well, Anthony was talking about a specific program that he has to ascend people up this ladder of the referral process, right? And the magic number is really, if you can get two people for every one person you get into the gym, right? And let's say you acquired that one initial person off of digital advertising, so you paid for that lead, right? So maybe it costs you a couple $100 to acquire that person, right? Well, if that person then allows you to acquire two more people off of that person, you've sliced your lead costs down and distributed among those three people. So for easy math, let's say it costs you $300 to fully acquire this client, right? Through the front end, through everything. You've now got three clients that you acquired for $100, right? So the math is just astronomical in terms of how much it can grow your business. But people a lot of the time do a piss poor job of asking for the referral, building it into their system, building it into their program, and making it something that your clients actually do on a regular basis. And part of that starts with having a good product, right? Because people aren't going to refer to a bad product. So if you have a bad product, that's a deeper fix that needs to be done than what we're going to tell you on the podcast today. But there needs to be a structured system around how you're asking for referrals and what you're doing around that program.
Yeah. And I think too, one of the things that I've heard gym owners do, I don't know how I want to word this right now, because I don't want to, there's so many different, when I hear referrals with gyms, someone's probably sitting here thinking, okay, yeah, I get referrals from my clients, but we're talking about an exact action that requires you to actually get the referral from the person, not sitting back and waiting for that referral to come to you. Because we all get that, right? That happens. Your clients are going to always recommend someone to come to you, but you can't rely on that way of doing it. You have to make it a system so that you're reliably getting those clients in right away. And I know the one thing that I think is the best thing to do this is at point of sale. Point of sale, right after they sign up, you, and this is key, the offer to them for the referral has to be huge. So you have to do something that's good so that they won't say no. So sometimes what we do is if the spouse is kind of the objection, oh, I don't know, my husband might not let me sign up, or my wife, I have to ask my wife. What we'll typically do is we'll say, okay, no problem. You know, if we get you signed up today, I'll give you a free month to give to your wife. So that's, I'm generating that referral by giving the big thing to them. So you need to be able to put those types of systems in place and not being there, sitting there hoping and praying that a referral calls you, because it's not going to happen.
No, it doesn't happen like that. And when you're in the beginning, or maybe you haven't quite conceptualized this part of your business yet, you sit there and you just go, well, what's your strategy? Well, what's your marketing strategy? How do you grow your business? Well, we're just word of mouth. Every business owner that I've ever heard that says we're just word of mouth, it means that they don't have any structure.
They're breaking even.
Yeah, they're breaking even, right? They're not profitable. They don't have any structure in place, nothing, right? So they say we're just word of mouth. That's a cop out to say, I don't have a strategy, right?
Yeah.
And so when we actually have this strategy around the referral generation, right? Anthony does a lot more point of sale work. And sorry if you guys can hear my dog in the background, but Anthony has a lot more of a point of sale strategy, right? We sometimes use the point of sale strategy, but the biggest thing that's worked for us referral wise is, drum roll please, the business savior is bring a buddy week. Yeah. Okay. This thing works like clockwork all the time. The best buddy week we ever did, we generated 9 referrals in 1 week and closed 7 of them on a year agreement.
Yeah.
Okay.
Buddy week is the best.
It costs us nothing, right? That's the cool thing. It costs you nothing to ask for a referral, right?
How many times a year do you do buddy week again? 4?
We do buddy week every other month. So six times a year. Yeah. Cause we don't want it to get too watered down or whatever. We want people to be excited about it. And it's very simple. And, you know, if you guys reach out to us, we can give you the whole play, the entire play for it. Right. But we'll go over it in briefly now. It's very simple. You send out emails, text messages, and notifications to your member base, letting them know that Buddy Week's coming up, asking them in session, there's specific scripting that my coaches have, asking them in session, who they're going to bring in, right? Not if they have somebody to bring in, but who they're going to bring in, right? It's subtle, but it makes a difference. And you book them in for sessions in your small group, because it doesn't cost you anything to have them in your small group either, right? Because that session is already generating revenue for your business.
Right.
So it's an opportunity to show them, you have a conversation with them in regards to what you can help them with, and schedule them for a consultation. And in that consultation, you close them on either your front end offer or your continuity offer in that meeting. But it's free leads, and these clients want to bring their friends in because they're having so much success in your facility. But if you gamify it and you make it an event and you make it this thing where it's like, this is Buddy Week, this is the chance, right? You could tell your members, oh, you can bring a friend in anytime you want. That doesn't work.
No, it doesn't. I've tried that. It doesn't work.
It doesn't work because they don't have urgency to the offer, right? It's going to go away. I mean, why do you think that you go to Costco and there's kayaks everywhere in the summertime, and then all of a sudden they're gone, right? That's a seasonal play. But at the same time, or you have a certain product that you see there, and then all of a sudden it's not there anymore. It's the Costco effect. That's why you go in, and that's why you have so much urgency to buy the seasonal products, because you know they're going to go away. So if people don't know when the next Buddy Week's going to be, because my clients don't know that it's every other month. They just know when it's coming about, right? They don't know when it's going to happen again. They don't think they can bring people in for free outside of Buddy Week. I have clients that come up to me and say, hey, I have a friend I want to bring in, but when is the next Buddy Week, right? like, because it's such an ingrained part of the way that the system works, that there's urgency and scarcity around that week of referral generation. And you can plan to have those referrals coming into your facility so that your staff can manage all those referrals coming in. So it's very ironclad and has been a thing that I've worked into my business since the very beginning, and it always works and it's always awesome.
One of the things that we do a lot is we ask for it at point of sale. And I was actually having a meeting with my sales staff the other day because I think we need to improve it. But the key is, when asking for it at point of sale, is you need to have a really, really good offer. We've tried so much stuff at point of sale, like, okay, you know, you here are guest passes, and we actually used to give out guest passes and nobody returned them. So that was a fail. I think you have to have a really crazy offer for the person. You know, is it worth it for you to give away a month free to somebody's friends? Him, you know, Jimmy, you just signed up for our gym today. I'm going to give you 2 free months to give away to your friends. Is that worth it for you to do that? That's like a really good ask versus, okay, here's some guest passes, you know, let me know. Whereas if I gave Jimmy 2 guest passes for a month, you know, Jimmy, who do you know that would want to come and get a month membership for free? Maybe the person doesn't sign up, but maybe they do.
And it's no skin off your back as the owner or the operator, because you have slots in your small group sessions, you have slots in your bootcamp, whatever the business is that you're building and growing, you have spots available, or you wouldn't be having to acquire new clients if you didn't have spots available. So you have spots available. So why not fill one of those spots with somebody that can potentially become a paying member? Right? And who are the best people and the most often closed clients, but referrals, right? There's that third party verification. So if you're spending $200 to acquire a lead or to acquire a client, excuse me, full client acquisition through digital means, what is your cost of a month free of training, right?
Yeah.
Okay. They're spending $300 for the month or $400, whatever it may be. Well, okay. Well, you acquired that client who is much more likely to stick with your service longer because their friend is there. So it's definitely worth it. And you have to do the math and ask yourself, right? But is it worth it to give a month away for free for a referral? I say yes every day and twice on Sunday personally.
Yeah.
But that's up to you to decide.
So in my earlier days in my career, I was a personal trainer. I was working at a big box gym. And I had, you know, in the big box gym, the way they get clients was you gave everybody a free session. So this woman came in and she really didn't have the money. And she was like one of those people, you know, that's not going to buy from like a mile down the road. You're like, oh, great. This is what I got to waste my time with now. But I was like, you know what? This lady, I really wanted to help the lady. Like, I really liked her story. So I took a lot of time. I think I spent with her like 2 hours and I really spent a lot of time and I wrote out like a plan for her and I gave her all this stuff. And I didn't even try to sell her. I just gave it to her and I said, you know, good luck. If you have any questions, I'm here. Blah, blah, blah. You can always ask me, blah, blah, blah. That lady, that 2 hours was the best time I've ever spent. She sent me over the next couple of weeks, 6 clients that stayed with me for years. So that 2 hour interaction was well worth the 2 hours to do it just because of what I got in return for that. So you never know who might lead you to who. And it's funny because you can even do it even one step more. If that buddy comes in, maybe you invite the buddy's buddy to come in. Now you're 3 people deep and you never know. Maybe the buddy doesn't sign up, but the buddy's buddy signs up.
Right.
There's so many different ways to do it. The one thing I will say, it's very hard to keep track of that stuff. So you got to make sure you keep track of it and you have to stay on top of it. You have to follow up with people because people forget. And we think all the time, you know, as gym owners, I think we have like this lock in our brain. You know, you mentioned that you do buddy week 6 times a year, right? 3 every other month. So now in our mind, we're like, oh my God, they're going to know buddy week is coming up again. They know it's every other month. They don't know. We think they know. They don't pay attention to that. They got other things going on. They got their life, their kids, their family, whatever is going on in their life. They don't. You think they care about buddy week in your gym? So no. They have no idea what you did last month.
Right.
You know, it's so funny because we think, oh my God, they're going to know it's buddy week. They know it's coming up. They know it's a scam or play. You know, we're putting these things in our minds. It's like, they don't know. They won't remember. So you don't have to worry about it. But you have to stay on top of them for it, was my whole point in saying.
Yeah. And I'd like to, you know, reiterate that, Anthony. It's like, even though you think like, oh, they have a free month, it's so valuable, they should just use it. Like, why are they not using it? Why do I have to follow up with them to get them to use something for free? It's a free thing. And I have to do more work to get them to use a free thing. you damn well better bet that you do have to do that work.
Yeah.
Right. Because it's not top of mind for them. Right. Yeah. They have this free thing. I mean, how many times you get a free thing in the mail and you go, okay, or your friend gives you like, you know, oh, here's a free voucher to whatever, you know, food place or whatever. How often do you think about that thing? You don't. Yeah. Right. So when you give them the free month deal, you are now responsible for following up with that free month. And the best way to give out a free month is to get the contact information of the person that will be receiving it. So the phone number, the email, then you can continually follow, put them back into the system that you already have built for lead gen and lead follow-up and put them into that system and call them and call them and call them and call them. Because if they don't use it, it's a waste, right?
Yeah. Exactly. What we do, and this is a quick tip for you guys to do, is what we do is we usually get the person's number and then we do a three-way text with us, the client, and the person. Mm-hmm. So this way they're all in there. And this way, when the person who's getting the text opens their phone and says, oh, look, Jimmy. Oh, and Jimmy joined the gym and here's the Jimmy's trainer. So it doesn't look like, oh, you know, who the fuck is texting me?
Exactly.
So it looks more, you know, legit. But yeah, that's the number one play to grow your gym. Buddy Week. Buddy Week and referrals are your best friend. So if you want to increase your profits and make more money and take home more money, you have to be doing something legitimately on your calendar, on your marketing calendar, every other month. I definitely think that's the best cadence, every other month. And you don't have to do Buddy Week, so to say. You could spice it up and make it like, you know, in February, you couples train for free, or, you know, you could kind of throw those little spices in there. I mean, I'm sure you do that. I don't know. What are the things that you usually call them?
Yeah, well, I mean, Buddy Week as it exists is just a constant on our calendar, but we do seasonal promotions where, like, you know, a spouse will train half off or whatever it may be, right? You give them a discount, you make the offer good enough, you make it seasonal, you play with the calendar as it exists, and you can kind of mess with things seasonally or holiday based just to spice it up and give it a little more you know, freshness or you know, consistency with the schedule, because everybody's kind of thinking about certain things at certain times of year. So you can always mess around with that stuff. But for the most part, as long as you have a consistent referral generation play that's in your marketing calendar on a regular basis, you've packed a referral generation play into your system, like Anthony has, much better than I have. We don't do as well at that as he does. But we were kind of the Buddy Week people. So that's just how we've done it. Right. And so those are the referral generating strategies that you can use inside of your gym to get more profits and acquire more clients.
All right, guys, if you are interested in getting more profits, like Jimmy said, just click that link below and that will bring you right directly to us. If you're interested in taking yourself and your gym to the next level to learn how you can be like us right now, sitting back, our gyms are doing their thing and we're here talking to you guys. So, all right, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.